Hey girl, hey! No, I'm just kidding. Okay, now I'm getting to this makeup, this butterfly, you know, thing that we got going. This is a chit chat, get ready with me, even though I'm not really going anywhere. I am just gonna, it's really like a chit chat. Do my makeup with me, watch me do my makeup. It's not a tutorial, y'all are just gonna watch me do my makeup. I think I'm gonna start this series because a lot of people always tell me, like, I always ask on my Instagram, like, what do you guys want to see on my channel? And everybody always tells me to do girl chat, like girl talk on my channel. And like when I'm like talking to my friends and stuff like that about like my channel and stuff like that, they always say like, you should do girl talk, like do some girl talk. So I thought, what a better way to start off this little series and then just like watching, letting you guys like watch me do my makeup. And let's be honest, like nobody is looking to see any like a brown smoky eye, okay? You want to see like the creative stuff, and really like this editorial type of makeup is really like what I like to do anyway. So yeah, I'm gonna be doing a lot more of these. Will you guys just watch me do my makeup and like some cool creative looks, and we do some chit chat. So this topic is going to be losing friends. So I actually have had this video in my mind, like I have a lot of YouTube ideas or whatever, and I just thought like losing friends is such a relatable topic. I feel like everybody can relate to losing friends. Everybody has lost friends in their life, and let's be clear, if you're a real one, you don't have many friends and you don't really fool around with a lot of people. So let's be clear, this video is not to bash anybody, or it's not to like talk about one person or one group of people or be shady or anything like that to anybody. This is really just really to give you guys like some advice and like some insight, or just like things that I've learned, just like being a girl and just growing and just running into different friends and things like that, and just my point of view and advice. And if you're going through this, maybe you can relate, or maybe it's something you have going on that you're not really sure about. This video can give you a little clarity. So I definitely wrote down some topics that I have, and first I'm going to start off by talking about like feeling guilty for like having to like cut off friends, because I feel like that's something, number one, that I like struggle with. And just like a little background with me, I never really like had like a group of friends where I was just like, okay, this is where I belong, like this is like my group of people, like we are all like, I fit in with this. I feel like I've never fit in, like even in like school and things like that, like I never just had like a group of friends like this is where I fit in. Like I feel like I've like never really just fit in. I did have friends, you know, that I was with, you know, more, or you know, like just like when I did go out or things like that, or when I did do things, I was, you know, with, you know, mostly like the same group of people, but it wasn't more was so like, this is like where I belong, you know, type of deal. But basically like feeling guilty, because let's be honest, like I'm not gonna sit here and act like cutting off every friend was easy, or cutting off every friend. Now don't get me wrong, some people do make it easy for them to cut off. It's like, ooh, child, like have you ever had somebody where you just like, ooh, thank you, like I'm glad we're not friends, like good, I'm glad it ended or whatever. But mainly like feeling guilty just for like having to do what's best for you, and really just like really having to just like let people go, honestly. And I feel like we should normalize demoting friends to associates. like, normalize that, like, just because these are your friends now don't mean that they always have to be, like, your close friends. And something that I really learned, like, something that if I could tell myself a young, like, my younger self something, it would be, like, advice when it comes to friends. It would definitely be that I truly believe in different friends for different things. Like, I feel like everybody is not meant to be your true friend, and everybody isn't going to be your one true friend, and everybody isn't going to be, like, so loyal and honest and have your back and not do shady stuff behind your back and things like that. And I feel like we have to be able to differentiate, like, these are friends that are good for this, but they are not good, you know, she's cool to go out with, but this isn't somebody who I'm going to confide in or tell my business to. Or things like that. Like, being able to just differentiate, like, where friendship should go and, like, things like that. Like, I feel like that's how we get our feelings hurt. We think everybody, well, at least for me, in my case, I feel like that's where I got my feelings hurt with friendships. Feeling like everybody, you know, I was that true friend to everybody, and I was loyal and a good friend and was an honest friend and things like that. So I also feel like being, like, a good person, you do feel like you feel guilty for having to cut friends off who aren't really just for you, and, you know, just outgrowing friends and, like, just having to friends. It's like when you grow up, you have to start hanging with people that fit your future and not your past. Just outgrowing friends, different, like, morals. Like, people, like, are just like, you know, some people don't grow up. You're just being more mature. Or people, girls, you have to watch out for people who are, like, low-key shady. Or, like, you know, like, you gotta watch out for the little side jokes and things like that. Like, and watch who's laughing the hardest. And just, it's just like, okay, it's like, it's really, like, just, like, paying attention to those type of things and, like, people that are smiling your face. And it's just, like, it's, or, like, fake love. So it's just, like, you really can't take it to heart, but it's at the same time, it's just, like, okay, these are not my friends. These are not my true friends. And a lot of people will try to smile in your face. You know, people will try to play victim to you because they don't know, like, you know, what you know. Or, you know, it'd be like the situation be, like, small. But it's like, over a small fallout, like, God will expose how people really feel about you. And it's like, people don't know what you know. But it's like, they'll try to be, like, victim. Like, you know, they was never like that. And it's just like, for, it'd be like, sometimes you have to cut people off just because how they moved when the friendship was off. You know, it's like, some people, friends that I did have to cut off, I feel like it's like, I noticed, like, how you moved, like, when we wasn't cool. And it's like, for that, like, I don't really want to be, like, you know, back like that with you. It's like, even if me, I can forgive people, just because you forgive somebody does not require a reconnection. And I feel like we have to be stern with that. Like, yeah, you can forgive somebody, but that don't mean that they have to be back in your life. You know, you have to pay attention and be, you know, smarter. Everybody have different friendships, different definitions of friendship and what they feel like is loyalty or what they, you know, and that's okay. And that's perfectly fine. But it got to a point where, like, you know, when it's to a point where people are doing stuff to me that I would never do to them, or are being shady, or, you know, just about anything that, and it's just like, with me, I feel like if we're friends, I'm not gonna be shady with my friends or anything like that. And if, and it's just like, if you're being like that, I have to cut you off. Like, I can't be friends with you anymore. And that's okay. If you have friends like that, where it's just like, people are doing stuff to you that you would never do to them, they gotta go. Like, you gotta cut them off. Like, because that's not, it's not cool. And you gotta stop getting back cool with people that already crossed you. That's something that I really had to learn. you gotta really, like I said, pay attention to them fallouts, right? And pay attention to what people say when they are angry or when y'all do fall out. Pay attention to how people move. Like, you can't get back that cool with people that already crossed you. And like I said, feeling bad for it. And that's normal to feel guilty, especially when, like, you've known people for a long time. And you feel like, you know, when you are a forgiving person, you feel like, but it's just like some people you just cannot be like that cool with. And like I said, normalize demoting friends to associates. And I had that happen to me one time as well, where it was like, it was a group of people where it wasn't like I didn't want to be friends with them anymore. I just didn't want to be as close to them as I was, because it was just like, it's obvious we're not real friends. So I don't want to be around people all the time who are not my real friends. And that's just what it was. And it's not to be mean, you know, and I don't want to be mean, but it's just like, that's just what it was. You have to pay attention to the vibes. Pay attention to how you feel, like, when you're around certain people. And that's what I started to do. I would pay attention to how I felt when I got done, like, hanging out with certain people. And that's how I knew, like, who wasn't really for me. Like, after I hung out with them, I would feel, like, you know, just, like, annoyed or just, like, not, you know, or just, like, not, like, in a good mood or whatever. And it's just, like, you have to pay attention to that. That's your spirit. You know, that's the vibes. Like, vibes, energy doesn't lie. And you have to just really, I remember when I would hang out with a certain group of friends, like, these are my friends that I've been knowing, like, since high school, like, Bria and Patrick. I would realize, like, it was literally when it was, like, that, like, our little, like, circle with us, it would be, like, I would always feel, like, motivated. Every time we were linking up, we would always be, like, motivating each other. It was just like, you know, like, I noticed that every time I was done hanging out with them, I would always feel, you know, motivated. I felt like I was around real genuine love. That's why I'm saying, like, you gotta pay attention to the vibes. And it was like when I was around certain other people, it was like it wasn't really like that. I didn't really feel that, and I was picking up on energy and vibes, and I was just like, you know, I really have to, you know, separate myself. So you gotta cut them off. And I feel like everybody that's in my life, I feel like I have never lost a real friend, honestly.
And I just feel like, just because you lost me as a friend does not mean that you gained me as an enemy. I can't think of one person who I'm like, oh no, like, you know, I still want everybody to win, everybody to eat. You just can't eat with me. Like, you just can't win with me. Like, and that's just sometimes how it has to be. When people start to act funny, or people just aren't on your side, when people are doing things to you that you would never do to them, that's when you gotta know. You gotta know when to cut people off and do what's best for you.
And it's not always easy to break those friendships off. And you also have to look at yourself. Sometimes you have to make sure that you have to check yourself and see, you know, what could I have done better? Or was it something that I did? I do feel like that I am a very forgiving person. I know for people like me, when you are a forgiving person, you want to give people, you know, more chances, because, you know, nobody's perfect. But you just have to really create boundaries and really just know who's for you and who to let in and who, you know, because get mad and start to try to tell your business. That's why I be lying. But seriously, it's just like, fake friends are always like, you always gonna have fake friends. That's everybody. And sometimes it is like, dang, I really thought this person was my friend. But it's just like, you just gotta accept it and move on. Like, anybody that's gonna cross you over some money or cross you over dumb things, like anything petty, boys, anything that's like, to where it's just like, really? Like, it's just like, these are not your friends. You just gotta know when to spot it out. Like, if you're around people and your friend or your friend has friends that are being shady towards you and they don't speak up for you and they let it go on, that's not your friend. Make sure the people that are around you are really for you, and make sure that you're able to spot the fake love, because people gonna be fake to your face. Like, be able to spot that fake love and know when it's not genuine, and know the difference between people who are genuine and love you and people who don't. But at the end of the day, you have to do what's best for you, and you have to put yourself first and protect your own peace. And I feel like that's what it was for me with a lot of friendships. It was just like, yeah, I could forgive you, but I gotta protect my own peace and my own energy and what I know to be real and what I know is true. And I've never cut anybody off for like their first thing. If you don't see me around anybody, it ain't something off of one thing. You know what I'm saying? It's more so I've given people chances, you know. And if you've given people chances and you try with people and they still, you know, I keep a tally in my head. You know, I'm clocking everybody. I'm watching everybody, whether they know it or not, in my life. And I know who's for me and who's not for me. And you gotta know who's for you, who's not for you, and really move accordingly. And that's what that's about. And now we have the completed look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and this makeup. And if you want to see more, of course, subscribe. What are you waiting for? Tell everyone you know to subscribe. And also, if you like this video, give me a big thumbs up if you want to see more videos like this. Chit chat, girl talk, watch me do my makeup videos. Leave me some comments below on how you feel about friendship and losing friends, or leave me some topics for like future videos when I do my chit chat, girl talks. And yeah, like this video, subscribe. To everyone you know to subscribe, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.